Hey guys, welcome to Pen Industry. Hope you are doing good. I am Dr. Aishwarya with you for easy learning and better understanding. Don't forget, today our topic is theories of growth. Many of the scientists has given the theories on the growth. So today we are going to learn some of them. The theories of growth has divided into two parts. The first one is depending upon the area where growth center occur, growth center occur, where the growth center occur, the area. And another one is the concepts or hypothesis, the concept which they have made and the hypothesis which they have made on the basis of craniofacial growth. So first one, in area or where growth center occur, is it was given by Broody, genetic theory, GB. You can learn this as GB. That means genetic theory given by Broody. Sutural dominance theory, SS. Sutural dominance theory by Sisher. Functional matrix theory by Melvin Moss, MM. Functional matrix theory by Melvin Moss. Cartilaginous theory by CJ. CJ. Cartilaginous theory by James Scott. These four theories were on the area where growth center occur, and based on the concept or hypothesis of craniofacial growth, three theories was given. Von Lomborg compromise theory, it was given by Von Lomborg. Cybernetic theory, CP. Petrovic has given the cybernetic theory. Hunter and Love's growth equivalent theory. Hunter and Engelows has given the growth equivalent theory. These were the seven theories which we have to learn. So we will be going with these theories in detail. If you like the video, please subscribe and hit the bell icon for theory which we are going to learn about is genetic theory. It was given by Broody, as I have told you before, GB, genetic theory by Broody, based on the genetic factor. It was based on the name itself says that it is based on the genetic factor. It was based on the assumptions. The assumptions were made in this genetic theory. So nowadays we are not considering this theory because it was not having a proof. The Broody was not having a proof about this. It was given in 1941. But once you have to write or enumerate in your exam point of view. Second one is sutural dominance theory. It was given by Sitcher. Sitcher, what I have told you before, that SS, sutural Sitcher. Each suture, in this theory, what Sitcher has said that each suture have a genetic information, that every suture is having a genetic information which determined the amount of the growth occurring at the site of the suture. This means that every suture is having a growth site, that means how much the growth will going to take place. This genetic information is encoded in the suture. Sutures are growth centers. Sutures are growth centers which generate tissue separating force. I have given the video on growth centers and growth site. Before watching this video, please watch that video, growth center and versus growth site. This will help you to understand the theories in a better manner. Sutures are growth center which generate tissue separating force. That means sutures, they generate a tissue separating force. Generate a tissue separating force, they stretch, you can see that, this theory was disapproved because the reason was that sutures are growth site. As he has told, the sutures are growth centers, but in fact, the suture, when you will go with the fact, the sutures are growth site, they are not the growth centers. Okay, so this theory also disapproved. The first one is genetic theory. We have no proof, so we don't assume, we don't consider this. Sutural theory also we don't consider. एंड थर्ड वन इज कार्टिलेजिनस थियरी. इंटेंसिव ग्रोथ, दैट मीन्स द ग्रोथ विच इज टेकिंग प्लेस नेचुरली. नेचुरल ग्रोथ कंट्रोलिंग फैक्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट इन कार्टिलेज. नेचुरल ग्रोथ टेक्स प्लेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ कार्टिलेज एंड इन पेरिओस्टियम विद सूचर विच हैज ओनली सेकेंडरी एक्टिव. बट द पेरिओस्टियम विच आर विथ सूचर्स, द पेरिओस्टियम विच आर प्रेजेंट, दिस इज जस्ट थिंक दैट दिस इज द पेरिओस्टियम, दे आर हैविंग अ सूचर इन दैम, दे आर अटैच विद द सूचर, दे हैव द, दे डोंट हैव अ ग्रोथ फैक्टर बट दे हैव अ सेकेंडरी अडेप्टिव रोल. दैट मीन्स अडेप्टिव रोल, दैट मीन्स द दे विल स्ट्रेच, they will going to stretch and they will make a bone. The stretching will be there and they will make a bone. Or growth will takes place with the cartilaginous theory. That means periosteum with cartilage, they give a secondary adaptive role. And cartilaginous part of skull, while talking about the skull, the cartilaginous part of the skull act as a primary center of the growth. That means first the primary growth center is the skull, which they are having a cartilaginous part, they are the primary center of the growth. And in cartilaginous theory he has given CJ. I have told you about this CJ, no, James Scott. I have not written the name here, but you just James Scott CJ has given the nasal septum. He has told the nasal septum present in the nose, they are responsible for the nasomaxillary complex growth. That means as you can see in the picture, nasal septum is for nasomaxillary complex growth. And he has said that mandibular condyle cartilage, the cartilage in the picture, you can see that the condylar cartilage is a growth center present bilaterally, present both side of the body bilaterally with a U-shaped mandible in between. As you know that we have two condyles and the U-shaped mandible in between. So mandibular condylar cartilage is a growth center there present. So this was the cartilaginous theory. What he has said that intrinsic growth presence in the cartilage, periosteum with suture, they have a secondary adaptive role. I have underlined the main points. You can go with this and write in the exam point of view. Then he has talked about nasal septum and mandibular condylar cartilage. CJ, it was given by CJ, J means James Scott. If you will remember the name of the theory with the scientist or who has given this, you will be able to understand this theory very well. Genetic is GB, genetic Broody, sutural suture, CJ is cartilaginous theory, James Scott. Now we will go with the Van Lembos compromise theory. You might be thinking that I have not explained the functional matrix theory. I have not explained in this video because the video was getting vast. So to make the video shorter, I have given that theory in my another video. So you can watch easily by clicking the I button. Van Lembos compromise theory. Now we are going to study. He has considered the process of growth and development in conjunction with three theories. What he has done, he has considered the three theories in the single theory, that is functional matrix. He has taken the sutural theory and genetic theory all together for the growth and development process. He proposes five factors. The five factors were given by Van Lembos compromise theory. The first one was intrinsic genetic factor. Here the genetic factor inherent to craniofacial skeletal tissue. That is, the factors are inheriting, that is, they are transforming from parent to the baby in craniofacial skeletal tissue. The craniofacial skeletal tissue factor is inheriting. This is the intrinsic genetic factor. In local epigenetic factor, he has said that genetically determined, that means the genetic inheritance which is going on, that influence which originate from adjacent structure and space such as brain and eye. The adjacent structures and spaces, that is brain and eyes, were genetically determined by Van Lamborg compromise theory in local epigenetic factor. In general epigenetic factor, the genetically determined, that is the inheritance was taken place that was influencing the originate from distinct structures. Structures of sex hormones, growth hormones, etc. These structures were inheriting in general epigenetic. In local environmental factor, local genetic factor, the local genetic factor influences from the external environment. With the help of external environment, the local genetic factor was, non-genetic factor was influencing. And in general environment factor, general non-genetic influences from the external environment. That is, in local, the external environment was included with the local genetic factor, and general environment factor was there with the external environment factor. Okay. Here it was local, and here it was the general factors. Cybernetic theory. According to Pavlov, what he has said, everything affects everything, means whenever you are going to do something, that will going to affect something. And living organism never operate in a open loop mechanism. That means open loop mechanism is not taking place in the living organism. What is open loop mechanism? In open loop mechanism, inputs leads to response. That means whatever input you are going to put, that will be responding. Okay, that means everything affects everything. No feedback or regulation present. Here feedback is not present, and regulation and proper regulation is not present. So this is the cybernetic theory. No feedback and no regulation, only input leads to response. When you are going to give your input, then you are going to get the response. Here everything affects everything, and living organism never operate in the open loop. Okay. Hunter and Enlow has given the growth theory. Growth of a given regional part is compared with its specific counterpart, that is growth equivalent. Growth of a given regional part. When some regional part is given and it is specified or counterpart, it is compared with the counterpart, with the same thing. In this, Hunter has given this growth equivalent. Growth equivalent means the growth which is taking here and the year are same. And in regional balance, growth takes place in balance. The growth takes place here in balance. Imbalance, when the imbalance occur, it causes the protrusion and retrusion. When the imbalance will going to occur, some part will protrude and some part will retrude. Okay. Hunter and Enlow has given the growth equivalent theory. Just remember this growth equivalent theory in Hunter and Enlow, and in cybernetic, living organism never operate in open loop mechanism. Just remember this line and here growth equivalent. This line. Thank you for watching Pendentristy. If you like the video, please like, comment, share with your friends, with your batchmates, and don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon for the latest upcoming new videos. Thank you for watching Pen Dentistry. To know more about me, links are in description box. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for the latest videos.